Hello everyone, welcome back to physical education class. I hope you all are fit and safe at your home. My name is Shamsher Singh, physical education teacher from Cambridge International School, Dasua. As we discussed about chapter number 5, yoga, topic was relaxation techniques for improving concentration, yoga nidra. I hope you all understood this topic. Now we will start with the next term, yoga for concentration and related asanas. This topic is very important, so please listen carefully. Let's start the topic. First is concentration. Dear students, concentration is important for everyone and helps perform better in day-to-day life. Yoga is one of the best way to improve your concentration. Yoga for concentration helps people overcome the feelings of anxiety and focus on their work and achievements. It has been observed that there was significant increase in motivation and concentration among people who attended yoga classes and performed certain specific asanas. Next is benefits of yoga for concentration. There are some points. First is benefits within the body. Second is benefits outside the body. And third is yoga techniques that help in concentration. Let's start from first, benefits within the body. It helps to improve blood circulation, blood pressure, immunity, metabolism, as well as improvement in cardio, endurance, and other organs of the body. Benefits of yoga activities for kids. Balance and muscle tones, enhance flexibility, boosts confidence, improve overall health, increase concentration, improves mental health, increase positive self-image, and last, develop body awareness. Second point is benefits outside the body. It works as anti-aging factor, improve posture, energy balance, sleep, awareness, and many more. It also helps the person get rid of health problems internally and externally. Third point is yoga techniques that help in concentration. There are many yoga techniques that help a person improve his concentration and focus in whatever he does. Regular practice brings in positive results and the person is able to get a good memory power too. Next is following yoga asanas help in concentration. First asana is Sukh Asanas. In Sanskrit, the word Sukham, Sukham means delight or bliss, and asana means posture. This asana is basically a relaxing pose. One can perform this asana in the most comfortable and easy manner. This is basically concentration pose. This requires patience. This asana is one of the easiest asanas. Next is procedure. To perform Sukhasana, the following steps should be performed. How we can sit? First is sit on the mat with legs stretched out in front. Bend the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the left thigh. Use the hands to do this. Next is, now bend the leg, left leg, and place the left foot under the right leg. Keep the body balanced and easily erect. Extend the arms so that the wrists rest on the knees, palms turned upward. The tips of the thumbs should touch the tips of the index fingers with other fingers lying straight. Now, benefits. First, your back becomes stronger. This asana gives your knees and ankles a good stretch. It relaxes your brain. It spreads a sense of calm and peace through your mind and body. Next, your chest and collarbones are broadened. Next is your body alignment is improved. Practicing this asana helps elongate your spine. Next is contraindications. The person suffer from knee injury should not practice this asanas. It's very important. Next asana is Tad Asana. The word Tad in Sanskrit means palm tree. This asana is called Tad Asana because in this asana the person stands straight like a palm tree, stretching his whole body upwards. What is the procedure? Stand erect and place your legs slightly apart with your hands hanging alongside your body. You must make your thigh muscles firm. Lift your kneecaps while ensuring you do not harden the lower part of your belly. Strengthen the inner arches of your inner ankles as you lift them. Now imagine a stream of white light passing through your ankles up to your inner thighs, groin, spine, neck, all the way up to your head. Gently turn your upper thighs inward. Elongate the tailbone such that it is towards the floor. Lift the pubic such that it is closer to the navel. Look slightly upwards. Now breathe in and stretch your shoulders, arms and chest upwards. Raise your heels, making sure your body weight is on your toes. Feel the stretch in your body right from your feet to your head. Hold the pose for a few seconds, then exhale and release. Now benefits: it increases height of children. It develops leg muscles. It removes constipation. It gives stretch to whole body muscles. It develops physical and mental balance. It cures posture problems like scoliosis. Some precautions, very important. Knees should touch the ground in final positions. The inner upper arms should touch the respective ears. Stretch the arms and fingers in full capacity. Keep the head, neck, and the body in one straight line. Avoid bending forward or backward. Next asana is Padam Asana. Padam Asana is made of two words, Padam and Asana. Padma means lotus. The legs in the sitting position of this asana gives the appearance of a lotus. This is a meditative asana. Procedure: sit on the ground. Slowly fold the right leg and place right foot on the left thigh, close to the pelvic bone. The right heel should be pressing the lower part of the abdomen. Slowly and carefully fold the left leg and place it on right thigh. The heel should press lower part of abdomen. From Janana Mudra with your hands. For Janana Mudra, fold index finger and join the tips of your thumb and index finger. Keep other fingers straight. Keep the hands in Janana Mudra on knees. Keep the body straight and maintain the position. Remove left leg from the thigh and then remove right leg and come to the starting position. Benefits are: it is good for digestion. It stretches leg muscles and brings flexibility in legs. It is good for concentration and memory. It brings calmness and peace. Applications are, knees should touch the ground in final position. Keep head and spine erect and shoulders relaxed. Keep the arms relaxed in the final position. Do not bend forward and backward in the final posture. Do not tense the arms. Next asana is Nok Asana or Boat Yoga Pose. Noka in Sanskrit means boat. The final position of this asana resembles a boat, hence the name has been given Nok Asana. This asana can be performed both in supine and prone position. Now, procedure is starting position, lie down on your back. Keep your heels and toes together, arms by the side of your body. Rest your palms on the ground. While inhaling, raise your legs. Raise your head and upper part up to 45 degrees with respect to the rest of the body. Stretch and raise your arms and legs and maintain this posture for 10 seconds. Releasing position. To return to your original position, slowly bring down the head, chest and legs, arms back on the floor. Relax for some time. Now, benefits. In this asana, the posture of body stimulates the digestive system and relieves gastric problems. It helps in stabilizing the nervous system. It helps in improving concentration. It helps in burning fat. Now, precautions are, the trunk should be raised up to the navel level only. The hands should stretch straight away without bending at the elbow. Do not raise trunk or legs in unparalleled way. Next asana is Briksh Asana. This is also known as tree posture. This is a balancing asana. The Sanskrit word Briksh means tree. In the imagination of the tree, foot seems as a roots. Leg is the trunk, arms as the branches and leaves, head as top of the tree, all make the posture in the shape of a tree. Procedure is, starting position, stand with the feet together and the arms by the sides and gaze in front. Bend the right leg at the knee. Keep the sole of the right foot as high as possible in the inside of the left leg thigh. Balancing on the left foot, raise both the arms over the head and joining the palms together or may bring both the arms in the front of the chest with palms joined together. Hold the position for 10-15 seconds. Balancing on the left foot or right foot, it's your choice. Releasing position, take both the arms down by the side of the body. Bring down the right leg on the floor and stand erect. Repeat the procedure from left leg. Benefits: this asana helps to develop concentration, coordination, endurance, and balancing ability. Next is Purukshasana. Attention should be focused on any fixed point in front. Try maintaining the balance of the body on one leg. Do not bend the body in the final posture. Dear students, I hope you all understood this topic and you can do daily at home these asanas. If you have any queries regarding this topic, you can call me, you can message me. At the end, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thanks for joining me.